Hello everyone, welcome to part 152 of advanced ecom series in Laravel 8. So we are going to start working on the shipping charges for the orders. So there must be the shipping charge that the e-commerce website can charge for the orders. You can see in any of the website like Amazon or other websites, other e-commerce website, many of the buyer charge the shipping cost, and that is the courier charges. You can also say the courier charges, and you can, when you are going to place some order, like you will select the COD or some other payment method, there is the charge you are going to pay, that is the shipping charge, or we can say the courier charge, like rupees 100 200, whatever the courier charge is for your place, for your address, that charge will be applicable. So this shipping charge we can maintain in two types of shipping charge we are going to integrate. One is the simple way of integrating the shipping charge in e-commerce website, and one is the advanced way for integrating the shipping charge. In simple way, we will just integrate the country wise shipping charges, like if you are going to deliver anything in India, like if you will select your delivery address in India, then there is the particular shipping charge, and if you will select any other country, means you are going to maintain the country wise shipping charge. Every country will have its own shipping charge that you are going to maintain. Okay, in admin panel we are going to add the shipping charges for all the countries, and whatever the country user is going to select in his delivery address, that shipping charge we are going to charge the customer. Okay, we are going to apply that shipping charge. So that is the simple way. I'm going to define here as well so that it will be clear to you. So here types of shipping charges, or we can just write the shipping execute integrate shipping charges. Okay, so one is the simple way. See, in simple way we are going to do the country wise shipping. Okay, country wise shipping, every country is having its own shipping, and now after that we will work on the advanced way. In advanced way, there is country wise as well as product wise. Every product is having the shipping charge, product weight wise, product and weight wise, product as well as the weight. We are going to count the weight of every product. Okay, product weight wise shipping charge, weight wise shipping. So this is the advanced way in which we are going to check the weight of every product. Okay, so our shipping charge depends upon the weight of every product. So that is the advanced way that lot of websites used to do. Okay, but first of all we are going to do the simple way, and that is the country wise shipping. We are going to add the shipping charges for all the countries in admin panel that you can manage. Okay, so we are going to add the shipping module after orders module. Here we are going to add the shipping charges, and when you will click on the shipping charges, then you are going to check the list of all the countries, and you can update the shipping charges for all the countries, and that will be applicable here in our order view page. We are going to add the shipping charges of that delivered country. Okay, so let's start working on this one. We are going to work on the simple way first. Simple way, country wise shipping charges we are going to execute for the order. Okay, so we are going to execute the country wise shipping charges. That is the simple way of adding the shipping charge. And first of all we are going to create the table for the shipping charges, and here in our database we are going to create the new table for the shipping charges. We are going to create this table with the migration command, but here for the shipping charges table we are going to add a few of the columns here. I'm going to show you few of the columns, we are going to create the shipping charges table with migration shipping charges. This is the table we are going to create, and we are going to add the column like ID, country, shipping charges, shipping underscore charges. Okay, this is another column we are going to add. Then status, like you want to make the shipping charge any particular country you want to disable, you don't want to apply the shipping charge for any particular country, then we are going to make the status inactive. Then credit card at and updated at. So these columns we are going to add. So I am going to run the PHP artisan migrate command to create the migration file. PHP artisan make migration. Here we are going to add create shipping charges table. Okay, so we are going to open this migration file, create shipping charges table. This migration file has been created. Here we are going to add the columns that we want. Table string, first of all we are going to add the country table. So after that we are going to add the shipping charges table. Okay, shipping charges table, shipping charges column. First is the country column, then shipping charges column. And shipping charges column we can maintain in float value, we can maintain. Okay, so after that we are going to add the another column, and that is for the status, and we are going to have the tiny integer. Okay, tiny integer we are going to have for the status column. Okay, so these are the column, and timestamp is for the credit and updated. So ID, country, shipping underscore charges, then status. Okay, so these columns are fine. So now we can run php artisan migrate command, and you can see the table has been created. We can check here, we can go and we can check the shipping charges table has been created. You can see the table has been created now. So we are going to import the countries list here, and the shipping charges we are going to add from the admin panel itself, but we are going to import the country list, and we have the countries list here. Here is, so this list we are going to import. So we can do one thing here, we can export this countries list, and we can export like this. Okay, so after export we can check the country list here. So this is the country list that we want for our shipping charges table. And what we can do, we can open the shipping charges table from here, shipping charges, and here we can add one entry, one country from the table itself. Sometimes we require to do here. Okay, to save the time, we require, because we just want to export, we want its CSV so that we can import with the updated data. Okay, so in live projects we need to do like this. Okay, so we don't have that much time, so we need to update. We must have number of alternatives to do the similar task, and we need to decide in few seconds that which alternative is the best alternative, because we don't have that much time. Clients always want the things in hurry, and we need to decide. So this is one of the approach that I am sharing with you. So the country list we just require to update here like this. So here we will just give the country list. We have got country, and we can rename the column to country as well. And ID we can just increment the id list like this, and 100 we can give the 100 rupees for all the countries right now. Then we are going to update, okay, and status we are going to make the common status one for all like this. And here created and updated at, and this time must be year, month and date, okay. So this time date we are going to update, this date we require to update, we will check from where we can able to update the date. So we can make it like this one. Now it seems to be fine, and same date we are going to add here, and we are going to do it like this, okay. Just 1 minute, we are going to do now, just do like this, okay. So yeah, now our list is ready, and this list we are going to import, but first of all we are going to empty the earlier list, then we are going to import this new list that we have just updated, this list, okay. So we will do like this one and go, and here you can see the new list, okay. So the countries are ready, but these are ready in our table, but we want these countries here in our admin panel as well. So here we are required to add the shipping charges link, okay. But before that we also require to add the model for this table and also the controller file, okay. So we are going to create the model as well as controller. First we are going to create the model, PHP artisan make model, and here we need to see shipping charge. So underscore you will not come here, and S will start from caps. So we need to take care of these things, shipping and charge. This must be our model name, shipping charge, okay. So S will not come in the end, shipping charge must be there. We are going to create this model like this, okay. So we will also create the controller. So PHP artisan make controller, and we are going to make the controller in admin folder of admin controllers folder, okay, because it's the part of the admin panel right now. Shipping controller, we are going to name the controller like shipping controller, okay, admin shipping controller like this, okay. So you can able to see here ecom app HTTP, and here you can see the controllers, and you can see the two folders. We have created the controller in admin folder. Here you can see the shipping controller, okay. So we can open this controller, shipping controller, and here we can able to create the function, but before that we require to create the route for the shipping charges as well. And one more thing, we are going to add the admin sidebar as well, okay. So here after orders we are going to add the sidebar for shipping charges. We can do like this, and we can quickly write here the shipping charges, and here we are going to add the shipping charges here as well like this, okay. So here also we will write shipping charges like this, okay. So these are the few things that we can do. And here route we have created like this, admin slash shipping hyphen charges, and this route we are going to create in web.php file, but before that we will check here. Now it has been created, so we are going to create here route as well, shipping charges like this. Here route get, here we will add like view shipping charges route. We are going to add view shipping charges, not shipping charges. Here we will make it view shipping charges, that looks better, hyphen shipping charges. And now here also view shipping charges like this. Now the shipping controller, and view shipping charges function we are going to create in our next step. view shipping charts like this. Okay, so this function we are going to create here, public function view shipping charges, and here we are going to get all the shipping charges for all the countries from the shipping underscore charges table. So we can do like this, shipping underscore charges. So here we need to include the model as well, shipping charge model. So we are going to include that, use a shipping charge. Okay, so we are going to get from this model shipping charge, shipping charge get to array like this. Okay, so here we are going to add here like dollar shipping charges like this. So we are going to check here if we able to get the shipping charges of all here is some mistake, admin view hyphen shipping charges here and here. Okay, so we are going to refresh and we click on once again. Now you can see we able to get the array of all shipping charges. You can see the Afghanistan, Albania, alphabetical wise you can able to see that we get all the shipping charges from the shipping underscore charges table. Okay, so we able to debug it, we able to get the data. Now we able now we must return the data to the shipping underscore charges blade file that we are going to create in our next file. Next step, return view admin. Inside admin folder we are going to create a one shipping folder, and inside that we're going to create one file, shipping underscore charges, shipping charges like this we're going to create, and we are going to send this shipping charges to there like this. Okay, so these shipping charges we are going to send to this blade file that we are going to create. We'll create inside resources, then views, then admin, then here we are going to create one new folder, shipping folder, and inside the shipping folder we are going to create the new file. You know how to create the file if you are using Windows, then how to create the new file, it is easy in Windows, and in Mac you just need to create like this, touch and file name. We are going to create that view underscore shipping underscore charges dot play dot php file like this. Okay, so we are going to check here view shipping charges here. Okay, so we can get the data from anywhere else. We can get the data from orders create file. We want the design of that admin design with the data so that we can make the changes. We can get it like this, and then we can make the changes. We can just convert it to shipping charges. Okay, everywhere. And now see, we have the loop for shipping charges as well, and here we just want ID, here we want country, shipping charges, here also we are going to add shipping. Okay, shipping charges, then status. And actions. Okay, and here we are passing that shipping charges array. So this array, we are going to receive this array here, and here we are going to make it like this, shipping, and here see shipping ID. After that it must be shipping country here. Okay, country, there must be shipping charges. shipping charges. Okay, we have the shipping charges in INR. Okay, you can give your own currency, and after that see status, and for status we can copy from some other blade file that we are having, like products blade file, and this is the kind of status we are having. So we can copy this status here, and we can just replace with the update shipping status like this. And here also we can replace this, but we can leave it for the time being. Later on we will give the status. Okay, we can give it like this for the time being. Here we can give this, here we can update status like this. Okay, so and after status, here also we can give the updated date. Okay, so shipping charges status, and after status one more column, we want that when the shipping charge is updated. Okay, so we will write it like updated at, and here we can give like updated at like this. Okay, so after that the last column will come, not required. Okay, so the action column will come up, and action column also we can copy the edit action. Okay, so we can copy this action from here, no other action is required. And here we can write update shipping charges, and this link we will add later on. We can do this like this at this time, and rest of the thing seems to be fine. So now we are going to check here. We are going to disable this one. Okay, so see here, the shipping charges module is ready, but here we need to select this one, shipping charges, in the same way like we are selecting the another one. We can open any of the another module, like products controller we can open. Here we can give it in the same way, like this one, and here we will write shipping underscore charges, and also we need to add the session here as well. Okay, so now you can able to select this one, shipping charges here page. We are going to check and close. Okay, so we can give it like this, and now see here, the shipping charge is selected. Okay, so once you will select like orders, you will select orders is selecting, shipping charges you will select you. So here we able to get all the shipping charges of all the countries from the shipping underscore charges table that we have just created. Okay, so we able to get the shipping charges, and by default we have given the INR 100 for all the shipping charges, and all the status for all the shipping charges is enabled for now. Okay, so in next video we will work on the update of the shipping charges, so the client can able to update the shipping charges for any of the country, and also we are going to make its status active or inactive. Okay, so these two things we are going to work on in the next video. After that we are going to apply the shipping charges here for the order. Okay, so that thing also we are going to do in the simple way of adding shipping charges. So stay tuned for next video. I hope everything is clear up till now, and lot of other things we are going to do in future videos as well. Okay, so that's all for now. Have a nice time. Goodbye.